Hello, this is H.G. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Parasite Eve! Last time, we defeated Eve! Again! Even though she didn't die, but I guess we got her to run away or something? Or maybe she really is that much more powerful than us, and she's just leaving us alive because either she underestimates us, or is trying to manipulate us into doing what it really is she wants us to do. Just like all good JRPGs. But now we're going to go down the hole. From the basement to sewers! Yeah, these are pretty clean sewers. Well, let's take a look around. Oh, by the way, my inventory. Let me take a look here. Yeah, my inventory is kind of full here. Let's actually reload bullets there. And, how close? Oh, I'm gonna gain a level soon anyway. Okay. And when I gain a level, I'll get more inventory slots. So I don't need to worry about clearing inventory space yet. But I do want to get out of the way of all these guys. Get away, get away. I want to get closer to those guys, but not that close. Whoa. Okay, get down. Oh. I was gonna try and kill that other guy, but no. He keeps on shooting fire at me. But yeah, basically when you're surrounded like that, just get out of the way, try and keep your distance as much as you can. How did I fire? Oh, right, okay. I was like, I fired 6 bullets, 2 per, but I remember I killed one with a crit, with just one hit. So, got lucky there. Hooray! And we get a level with more bonus points. And by the way, speaking of bonus points, someone was reminding me, H.C. Bailey, when you gain a level there, when you gain a level, you get those bonus points. Whenever you finish a battle, you get those bonus points, right? And the amount of bonus points that you get will decrease depending on how many hits you've taken or damage or whatever it is. So, just something to keep in mind. Obviously, you want to take less hits. And you get more bonus points that way. So, I'm going to do the best I can with that. Oh, let's see. You know, let's use a medicine here, because this battle, well, these guys can deal quite a bit more damage than the previous ones. Okay, so we got a new enemy there, a giant frog, and that guy is pretty hard to dodge, so let's get out of the way. The reason the frog is so hard to dodge is because he has a really, really big tongue, and it can hit you practically from the other side of the screen, so not a whole lot we can do about that. Gonna try and kill that guy, but I can't, so let's just kill this guy instead. Wow, I'm getting pretty lucky with these crits here. You can tell it's a crit because the color of the font changes. But, alright, another level. Awesome. And more ammo there. So yeah, with bonus points, like I was saying, just take less hits, but we can't even do anything with bonus points yet, because we don't have enough. Well, we don't have enough of them, so. How do I have 4 bullets? I fired more than one bullet in that battle. Did I, like, reload and I just totally missed it somehow? Well, anyway, you go over here. Haha! New weapon! Even more powerful than the previous ones. I'm gonna equip that in a moment, but, I want to demonstrate something to you with the new weapon there, because it has triple shot there, so you can fire 3 bullets in a single round of combat instead of just the 2 that we've been doing. But I am gonna equip it. But 3 shots may not seem, or isn't, that much better than you might think it would be. It's not like Final Fantasy VII, where each time you can fire more, or do more and more attacks per round, you'll just deal proportionally more damage. Nah, it doesn't work that way. I mean, it's not quite split damage, but, well, you'll see. But anyway, go over here. More medicine. Awesome. And how's my inventory? Okay, we still got a little more space here. Let's see. Now, this part's a little tricky. Go up here. Well, I guess you can kind of see it. Yeah, you can see it. Okay, well, there's another treasure there. And, yeah, now we're full. So, let's use one of those. Because I'm never going to use medicines after this part. And over here. Or medicine 1, that is. But, all right. Offense plus 2. And I'm going to use that in just a moment, viewers. Not yet, though. Let's see. Okay, we are full, so I'm gonna need to, Because I want to demonstrate something with the new weapon at its base power, so I don't want to use the offense yet there. You know what? Let's just dump a medicine there. Whatever. Whenever I finish an area and I haven't used all my medicines, I just dump them anyway, because I need to clear space. Okay, so anyway, if you get between the top and the middle pillar there, go straight to the right. Haha! Secret passage! And treasure abound. Let's see. Cure poison. Don't care. No one can poison us here anyway. But the interesting thing about the status curing items in this game is that if you use them preemptively, well, it'll prevent the status from hitting you. So that can be pretty nice. I'm not going to use that, but for that reason, at least not right now, but you can if you want. Oh, right. Oh yeah, you can replace items with chests too, if your inventory is full there, so let's just dump that. Get this. Oh, nice! 2 offense plus 2. Sweet. Okay, well, let's get back out of here. I think that's all the treasure in this area. Yep, that would be all of it. So now let's go after where the little girl went there. I wonder, where's she going? She have something to do with Eve? I don't know. Well, let's find out. Bullets are full. Or the magazine is full, or whatever. Okay, now watch how much damage I'm going to deal to these guys. So let's get this first frog here. Okay, I'm going to fire 2 shots. Okay, so my base damage is 12 without the crit there. You saw that. So in 2 shots, I'm going to deal 24 damage, essentially, without crits, right? So now, let's equip that new weapon. It's a little stronger, but it's got 3 shots there. And see how much total damage I'm going to deal there. So switch weapons mid-battle there. Okay, so now let's see how much I deal here. 3 shots. Okay, that wasn't a good example. Let's try that one again. But anyway, so that was 9 damage there. If I dealt 3 shots, that should be 27 damage. Yeah, you see there? So even though I'm dealing 3 shots, I'm only dealing slightly more damage, or total damage per round, than I am with double shots. And the problem with triple shot is that, well, I'm going to be sitting on my ass 50% longer than with double shot. So with weapons that are slower, I prefer to use double shot, so that way I'm not, like, frozen in combat for as long. Even though it deals a little less damage, I like having that mobility. But if you have a faster weapon, then I'd probably go with triple shot. But in this case, I'm still going to stick with the triple shot anyway, just because it's more powerful. The base power is better, so. Okay, well, we got the new weapon there, so now let's use the offense plus 2 items on there. Just select the stat boost you want, give it to the weapon you want, and it adds it to that plus column there, which is basically your transferable stats. Yeah. But hold on, let me show it to you. Okay, yeah, there's the base stats there, and then there's the plus stats there. The plus stats are the ones that you can move around from one weapon to another. Can't do that right now, but we will be able to do that in the near future. So, okay, so let's sort weapons, so that way I can get my default weapon, or my equipped weapon up top there. And there we go. So, okay, so we got that. Let's see, would that be enough to get me to full? Just barely. Phew! Okay, good job there, Aya. And I think we're all set and ready to go. Not that I'm really going to need medicine anymore, but let's flip the switch there. That'll open up the gate. And of course, there's a telephone in the sewers. Absolutely. Why sewers would have telephones, I don't know. Maybe it's like a maintenance line or something? I don't know. I mean, how would you call a telephone like that? Like, what if someone had to call you back or something? They got a number on those things? I don't know. I know this may be a shock to viewers, but I'm not an expert on waste maintenance. Or whatever the technical term is for that. Ha ha! Got you trapped now. Where are you gonna go? Can't go down anymore. Well, that's because you are hot, Aya. Yeah, Yeah, that wouldn't be a good idea. I can take it by myself. So, are you gonna actually shoot her, or are you just gonna talk for a little while? Don't ask why, just shoot her. Please? Please shoot her? Simon says shoot her. Now? Where's that word? Mitochondria again. What kind of evolution? You're not gonna tell us, are you? Where are you gonna go? You're kind of trapped here, Eve. Whoa. You can fit through those bars? Yeah. You are such an idiot. I thought that was her who just went through the bars there, but now there's that other guy. What just happened? Did she just give us more boss time? She did! And of course, alligator, or crocodile, or whatever this thing is. I think it's an alligator. Is, yeah, electricity there. Now, the trick to this fight, well, there's two parts. There's the head and the tail there. You want to go after the tail first. So basically, what you want to do is go over here. You see how he turned clockwise there? And then his tail went counterclockwise. So I moved in the opposite direction that he turned. So that way he can't hit me. So whenever you see him suddenly turn towards you, that's when you want to go in the other direction there. And then you won't get hit. And unfortunately, I went the wrong way that time. Oh well. So let's go after the tail. A few more shots there. Ow! I guess I got a little too close there. I'm surprised it's taking me so many shots. Oh, one more shot! Come on! I shouldn't have taken that last big hit from him, but oh well. So yeah, first part, probably actually the harder part of the fight. Okay, wait for him to do another sudden turn. Okay, get out of the way. Ow! Yeah, I'll be fine. Okay, just wait for it. Actually, you know what? I'm not gonna chance it. I'm gonna heal up. But anyway, yeah, so that's basically what this guy does. You wait for him to make the sudden turn there, and then he's... Well, meanwhile, he's frozen, and I can hit him. Yes. Okay, so let's see if I can get another few shots in there. Not bad, not bad. Then he's gonna... He can sometimes do a charge at you, too. Like that. Just shoot him in the chin. That works, too. Okay, got him. Hooray! Yeah, I took way too many hits there, but... Oh, well. I still made it all the same. So, alright! And now we have over 100 bonus points and a Kevlar vest. Alright. So that's basically what I was saving all of my defense boosting items for, because I knew I was just gonna get another armor anyway. And really, well, usually, armor isn't that big of a deal. I mean, you wanna, you know, get better stuff, but really, it's the weapons where it's all at. You might not wanna stick around this area, dude. You might get set on fire. Well, there was your boyfriend. But maybe we don't want to get him involved. Well, we really don't know how she set everyone on fire either. Well, you're the only one here, so sure, why not? Or, okay, that's why not. Okay, never mind. Who is that guy anyway? Oh, what are you? You're like my double backup? What happened to all the other cops? Oh, probably get set on fire eventually. Well, at least he's alive. I would guess. We never actually see him again, I don't think. He just, like, left and that was it. And yeah, he's not important to the plot at all. Seriously. What do you mean you don't believe me? He really isn't. I don't know. I'm sorry. I don't know what came over me. That line just seemed amusing to me. No apparent reason. Never mind, viewers. Just pay no attention to my rambling. Might be nice to wear a bulletproof vest next time, though. Well, we did get the Kevlar. Why, Alligator would have a Kevlar bulletproof vest, I don't know. But, like I said, this is New York, so... That only counts as one use of mitochondria. I think Eve's just messing with you, Aya. I wouldn't worry about it. Pay no attention to her. Lies. Fiendish slander. I hope you like hearing Melissa's singing voice, because we're going to be hearing a lot of it throughout the game. 6 days. I thought it was 7 days until... Oh, right, New Year's Eve. I was thinking of New Year's Day. I was like, no, that would be 7 days. No, not six. Okay. It doesn't seem that terrifying to me. You seem to be handling it quite well, Aya. I mean, okay, you're a little tired. Hey, that's understandable. You see everyone get set on fire, and you gotta set your emotions aside and get the job done. Not a lot of people can do that. But how are we going to chase after Eve now? Find out next time on Let's Play Parasite Eve. This is H.C. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!